Less than one day after being arraigned yet again, many people are wondering, what is Donald Trump's legal strategy going to be with this January 6th case? Well, he apparently has come up with something, and it's a sophisticated strategy. It's a plea to the Supreme Court to please help me. It's filling his bleats these days. Some of them are long, I apologize, but he says, crazy, my political opponent has hit me with a barrage of weak lawsuits, including DA, AG, and other combinations of letters, which require massive amounts of my time and money to adjudicate. Resources that would have gone into ads and capital R rallies will now have to be spent fighting these radical left thugs in numerous courts throughout the country. I am leading in all capital P polls, including against Crooked Joe, but this is not a level playing field. It is election interference and the Supreme Court must intercede. MAGA. Now, it would be easy enough to say, that's just something he threw into a bleat, it doesn't mean anything. And the second half of that is definitely true. But no, it's popping up in more of them. So in this next one, you can see that because they're filing the cases must be unconstitutional. Is that a rhetorical question or? I don't know. See, the thing is, the Constitution is not as long as maybe he thinks, having not read it before. I don't think there's anything in there that says that you can't be charged with any crimes. And then, you know, you can go to this last one, and again, it's him complaining about the fact that these should have been filed a couple of years ago when he would have been totally fine with it, of course. And says, not fair and perhaps not legal. Again, the like, you sue me, no, I sue you defense, I guess is what he's going with. But I don't know exactly what the Supreme Court is supposed to do. They don't generally step into presidential elections other than 2000. But as of right now, they're not answering. The CNBC asked for comment, they didn't say anything. The Trump campaign spokesperson that was asked didn't say anything, probably because this is just a thing that he came up with and now he's just saying it all day long. But his lawyers are like, what are you talking about? The Supreme Court takes things up on appeal. There's no case, how would this work?
Yeah. So look, guys, of course I'm gonna make fun of, we're all gonna make fun of Donald Trump. I can't believe he was president, doesn't know one thing about our system of government, like not one thing. It's amazing, it's amazing. But there are two twists in the story. One is there's something that Trump said that I agree with, twist. And second of all, MAGA should be excited about this indictment, and it turns out they are. Okay, hold for those. But first, let's address the core issue here. Is the Supreme Court should take this up? How would they take it up? Like, there is no such thing as a case has not happened yet, and the Supreme Court's like, and it has not been appealed to the Supreme Court. It has not been addressed to the Supreme Court. No one has brought it to the Supreme Court. And the Supreme Court's like, that case, we don't like it. That's not a thing. It's like, how can I explain to people who don't understand our system of government? Not a thing. That's like saying, why hasn't Peter Pan ruled on this yet? You know, this is outrageous. He could just fly over and go, ba-ding, and the case is over. That's not a thing. It's not a, you have to go through the trial. It has to be appealed. And by the way, there has to be an issue of law for them to look at. And for them to say, oh, we're gonna take up the case because that's an interesting, controversial, matter of law that the Supreme Court should weigh in on because the 3rd District and the 11th District disagree, etc. But I mean, forget the 3rd District and the 11th District disagreeing, forget the matter of law. He just has no idea how our court system works at all, at all. It's stunning, it's stunning. Now, having said that, part of the reason I tweet, don't tell the guys on Twitter, okay? Or on X, it's because I wanna see the people's reaction. And unfortunately, this confirms for me what I've been seeing with a lot of folks in MAGA. They not only do they also not understand how the Supreme Court works, but they feel super offended when we point out how it actually works to Donald Trump. And they feel like they're getting called dumb. But brothers and sisters, you weren't president for 4 years, okay? You know, you're a dentist and you don't know how the Supreme Court works. God bless your heart, you know how teeth work, okay? You're an accountant, you're a plumber, it's okay, it's okay. But he was president for 4 years. He's supposed to know how the Supreme Court works, and he doesn't have a single clue. And forget the fact that he's deeply unintelligent. I mean, it's shocking how unintelligent he is. But forget that, say that he's brilliant, I don't care. Think about how lazy he is, that he didn't bother figuring, he put three people on the Supreme Court and he doesn't have one clue as to how it works. How lazy do you have to be that you're president of the United States? You didn't ask a single person, hey, how does a case go to the Supreme Court? That's just unbelievable. But if you still like that, there's nothing I can do to help you, Maz.
Well, Cenk, he doesn't know how anything works. We've found that out now, or we've known that for a long time. He started with his father giving him money and then he blew it and several bankruptcies. And then from there, he went on with his failed university. He's very good at failing. He doesn't know how anything works. He's not curious. He doesn't read. He's never read a book. And what you guys are talking about with him trying to get the Supreme Court involved when there's actually no case, it would be like a player in tennis challenging the call before the serve was made. Like, they haven't even served yet. And he's like, I challenge. And they go, well, that guy has this. We don't know. We don't even know if the ball is going to be in or out. I challenge. So maybe what we can do is he could expedite, if he's really this excited to get to the Supreme Court, he could just come out and say, I'm guilty of all this stuff. Mm-hmm. And then say, I want to jump from appeals and then get the appeal court. When he goes to appeals, go, I'm still guilty of all this stuff. And then get to the Supreme Court and see if these people that he put on there that are hardcore conservatives would actually judge in his favor about, I guess he's saying that there's some sort of election interference going on here. I mean, it's what you said, you post stuff on Twitter to get their reaction. I just am still shocked at the denialism that some of these people go through, because whether I'm a Obama guy or a Biden guy or a Trump guy or whatever guy, if my guy's committing a lot of crimes, at some point I go, okay, he is the Al Capone of politics. So yeah, he's guilty, but I'm racist enough that I'm gonna vote for him regardless. I would at least appreciate that. But they have bought into this hook, line, and sinker of how this is a big, big election interference thing going on here. They look right past the fact that the guy is clearly guilty. And now he's just throwing stuff. Clearly, he's still getting legal advice from John Eastman and Rudy Giuliani, who told him, just go for the Supreme Court. That's probably who told him to go for it.
Yeah. Yeah, he's got that legal dream team. Sorry, not dream team, set of co-conspirators. Apologies. And again, look, they have to say stuff like this because Donald Trump or whoever, his legal spokespeople, they can't do an interview where they say, okay, here's the indictment. This is wrong. We have proof this didn't happen. That's not illegal. They can't do that because it's terrible to even look at it and they know that they're wrong. So they have to ignore all of that and just argue about stuff that's not even up for debate. The Supreme Court should just cancel it. It's about the First Amendment. All this stuff that has nothing to do with the actual case that we're gonna have. And then honestly, it prepares their base to not understand what happens when it begins to happen. When the actual trial happens, if we get details out of it, they're not going to know what's going on because they think it's about whether he has a First Amendment right to think something or whatever. But anyway, Cenk mentioned that we're gonna make fun of him, and I have some material that I think actually will play into that quite well. Donald Trump is clearly mad about all of these indictments, but a few specific things stand out that have angered him more than others. Take a look at this.
But I am told that the former president, one thing that irked him particularly was during that hearing today that lasted about 27 minutes, was when the magistrate judge referred to him as simply Mr. Trump. That may not sound odd to anyone else, but he is still referred to by his former title, President Trump, when he's at his Bedminster Golf Club in New Jersey, as he is tonight, or at Mar-a-Lago.
Just called by his name. That's not enough for him anymore. He didn't like that. From reports coming from inside of the courtroom, he didn't like having to wait for the judge to arrive. Generally, he's showed up, the judge is there. This time, he had to wait around. He didn't like that. And if that annoys him, then you know, we're gonna get another opportunity potentially for this because Fannie Willis is expected to seek indictments this month and we could get those details in the coming weeks. He could be arraigned yet again within a month and we'll see if maybe the judge treats him a little bit nicer in that case.
Yeah, well, this one is unfortunately universal. I've seen many Democrats who say, Christie, what do you mean? It's Congresswoman Smith or Assemblywoman Smith. So everybody who goes to Washington gets a giant ego. So I could see a Democratic president, even if they're not foolish enough to make it public, being super mad that not being called President Biden or President Obama. Like if somebody calls Obama just Barack, I bet not only him, but all of Washington would be deeply offended. So let's keep it real. I mean, they'd be President Obama to you, you dirty progressive. Okay, you know how it is, come on. So that, look, I pardon him on that. He's like, pardon? Yes, I finally got one. Okay, but that's not the thing that I think he's right about. Look, going back to why a lot of the MAGA guys don't get it. And I did, look, what I'm saying is potentially more insulting. I don't mean to be, but like tons of them, because it's not their job to be political folks, but then they think they're political folks, don't understand the basics of a lot of things. Like, it's, you don't have a First Amendment right to say anything you like. If you go into a bank, as one of our members pointed out yesterday, you go into a bank and say, hey, I have a gun in my pocket, why don't you give me $10,000? And go, whoa, freedom of speech. Mm-hmm. No, that's a crime, you're sticking up the bank. The fact that the crime was committed by you saying something doesn't mean you have a First Amendment right to. But tons of comments online, they don't understand that at all. The minute they say First Amendment, they're like, oh yeah, he just said it. You can say anything you want, that's what the Constitution says. No, it doesn't, brothers and sisters, no it doesn't. Mm-hmm. Look guys, I talked to a bunch of Republicans, and I realized that they didn't think that, like for me, the straw that should have broke every camel's back to smithereens was when he said, well, maybe we should inject bleach to cure COVID. I was like, aren't we done with this guy? That's the craziest, I can't believe he said it. And I talked to a bunch of Republicans and they're like, well, it could have worked. And I was like, oh my God, the reason why they haven't turned on him is because they think it might have worked. Like the crazy stuff he's saying, they're going, not all of them by a long shot, but a pretty significant chunk are like, oh yeah, why not? Yeah, why not have the Supreme Court just cancel the case? No, that's not how it works, right? So, but the one part I do agree is, why did they take 2.5 years? I'm furious that they took 2.5 years to get to do these cases. And was it because they wanted it right in the middle of the political season? I don't know. I'm not even foreclosing the possibility that it was because of that. It might have been, I don't know. More likely, slightly more likely, is Merrick Garland is such a weak jellyfish blob of a human being. He's like, I don't know, should I? And eventually he didn't even do it. He got a special counsel who did it. Mm-hmm. So no, they should have done this right away. Shouldn't have been anywhere near the election. Because now he gets to whine about the election. And every Republican is like, aha, it's because he's doing well in the polls.
But really fast though, like if they had done it 2 years ago, it would be near the midterms. If they did it a year before that, it's when we're choosing our candidates for the midterms.
No,
they're
John,
always gonna complain.
John, yes. John's 100% right. They're always gonna complain. They're always gonna have some excuse. Yeah, distraction from the Hunter Biden laptop, right? No, I know that. I care about reality, not their reaction.
Okay.
The reality is, God damn it, now it's right in the middle of his election.
Yeah.
Not a midterm election, not Joe Billy Bob's election, but his election. And he is leading by 40 points on the Republican side, and he is tied with or beating Biden in half the polls. So now it looks terrible. And besides which, forget the looking terrible. You're supposed to do it right away, not wait around and see if it's a convenient season. So Merrick Garland, I think, has been a total disaster. Yeah. So that's my take on that. I have one other thing, but go ahead, Moss.
Yeah, first of all, going back to the fact that he's offended that she called him Mr. Trump, I'm offended that she didn't call him Dum Dum. That would have been great if she would be like, hey, Dum Dum, how do you plead? Secondly, I know what you're talking about, Cenk, when you say that the title, like, you know, they all want to be congressman, congresswoman. I'm originally from Iran. I prefer you guys call me Shah Maz. And Cenk, I guess your Turkish background, you'd be Sultan Cenk, I think. I'm not quite sure.
Well, Cenk Bey. Bey as in like sir, honorable, you know,
yes,
Cenk
sir.
Bey.
But listen, the thing about the taking time, I'm like you, I wish they would have started a lot earlier. But the fact is, whatever they did and however they did it, it was beautiful to watch Jack Smith. I actually got tears in my eyes, tears of pride when I was hearing Jack Smith do the press conference about all of the stuff and how clear he was about how Trump is guilty of a crime here. And that goes back to what you were talking about earlier, about how his supporters are saying free speech, free speech. These people, they have people come out, there's talking points, and they just throw things against the wall, hoping something sticks. So one of the things they said was, well, he was just listening to the advice of these lawyers who were experts. And I tweeted about, I said, well, you know, that didn't work out for the Manson murderers, because they said, we're just listening to Charlie Manson. And he said, kill people, we kill people. So they keep throwing out excuses and they try stuff. And one of the ones you're saying right now is this whole thing with the free speech. And somebody was pointing out very clearly that you can't use free speech to commit fraud. So I can't use my free speech to call somebody and say, hi, yes, I'm a banker. Give me your bank information because I'm going to be putting money into your account and then take money out of your account. So clearly, this guy used his quote unquote free speech to be part of this big conspiracy and fraud. And you and I and all of us can see it. But as you said, all the Republicans are using it as a talking point. And then you see these people at the Trump rallies just kind of reiterating, just they reiterate statements that don't really connect. And they go, yeah, you know, deep state, the Bunner, the Biden Hunter, you know, laptop and free speech. They just throw out these words and none of it makes any sense. And unfortunately, we end up where we are, where, as you said, Trump is leading the Republicans by, I don't know, 70%, whatever, he's like 70% approval or 70% want him, which shows you that there's 30% that doesn't of Republicans. And overall, I would say the odds of him winning a general are very low, which again goes back to, if you're a true Republican and you really want to have a chance here, you really need to find a candidate that doesn't come with all this baggage. So I don't know what they're thinking. And I hope the guy, if he does end up being their candidate, that he's in a jumpsuit, an orange jumpsuit come election day.
Yeah. So last thing is, you know, I, again, trolling MAGA a tiny bit, put out a statement that you guys have heard me say on air before, which is, hey, you guys should be super excited about this case, because if Trump actually won the election, then he couldn't have lied about winning the election, because he won it. It was true. He would win the case easily, right? So great, bring out your mules and your Krakens, and you'll get to prove that Trump finally won the election. So I guess you guys are excited about that, right? And then I looked at the mentions, hundreds of comments, totally genuine. You could tell when people are trolling and not, saying, yeah, we are super excited. This is great. He's finally going to be vindicated. We're going to get to show you guys that we won the election. Guys, they genuinely believe it. I know that it sounds amazing and unbelievable, but tens of millions of people in this country like genuinely think Trump won, and they're like, oh, finally, we're gonna show the evidence that he's gonna be vindicated.
Yeah.
So that's why the trial might be more interesting than we realize, because some of those people, doesn't matter what happens, especially if he gets off on a technicality, they're gonna be like, we knew it, Trump won the election. You'll be like, what? How is that logically connected, right? Mm-hmm. But some of them might see the truth for the first time in their lives and be like, no, really? No. So we'll see.
I think Alina Haba is just gonna roll an old school elementary school TV in, play 2000 Mules, and then rest her case. I think that's gonna be it. I think that the evidence is strong. You know, it's almost too bad that they weren't able to try to relitigate the election in like 50 or 60 lawsuits right after it. They should have done that and proven that it was stolen. Anyway, I just want to play one more, the last video, number three, just because you mentioned how this could potentially interfere with his presidential bid. Well, I guess even I didn't know how much it could potentially interfere. Take a look at this.
You've got the GOP debate in August, but below that, August 28th, the next hearing in the January 6th case, October 2nd, Trump's civil suit. January 15th, the E. Carroll defamation suit. January 15th, Iowa caucuses. Super Tuesday, March 5th, pyramid scheme investigation. January 29th, and it goes on. These are layered on top of each other. How can any person run an election and handle all of this on one plate?
Okay, so the stated intent of that segment, as well as what she was saying, was this is unfair to Trump, but I kind of feel like that's the segment you run when you don't like Trump very much, because That's a lot to put on one screen all at once. It does not look good for Trump. And honestly, Edwin and I didn't even know about the pyramid scheme thing. So I feel like that's what you do when you kind of want to stick it to Trump a little bit, but maybe I'm wrong.
Look, guys, there's no end to the madness. So one, that's part of why I thought the trials should have begun immediately. What are you waiting 2.5 years for? And it makes it look not great when you have all those things coinciding exactly with the election. So that's to be fair to the right wing, right? On the other hand, how do you look at that? It's the Zucker line I keep using. When he got ousted from CNN, he said, well, I did have the affair that I shouldn't have had. So I gave him the gun and they shot me with it. And so Trump has given them like 8 Gatling guns. And they're like, in the middle. Why did you steal the documents, you idiot? You buffoon. Why did you steal top secret documents and refuse to give them back? And then have your goons carry them around Mar-a-Lago like Benny Hill cast characters. And then go, oh, delete the tapes. We'll delete them. Then they won't see them. Oh, God, you're so dumb and you're such a criminal. You can't help yourself. But meanwhile, back at the ranch, the right wing is at another planet. And Kerry Lake is like, this is perfect.
Yep.
This way, when Trump wins the case, we'll reinstate him as president right now.
Calendar is funny because you see he's got more court dates than he does election dates. It's almost like the election is interfering with his court schedule. It's the other way around. And it's almost like I could imagine if like, this is what like Pablo Escobar's calendar must have looked like. And on the top, he's like, you know, pick up my kid from soccer, you know, kill my rival. And then these are all court dates. That's the Pablo Escobar version of a calendar. I mean, that guy's busy. He's got a lot going on. Good thing he doesn't pay attention to his kids, because then he'd have to spend time with Eric and the rest. So, you know, at least he's got that going for him.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.